like I said, I'm not a street preacher, but I support the street preachers. I love them. I love anybody. I like people that put out tracts. If you're not bold, then what are you? You're cold. So anyway, this is a story about the sun. And if we don't have the sun, he that has the sun has life. He that has not the Son of God hath not life, nor shall see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. 3:36 in John. A wealthy man and his son loved to collect rare works of art. They had everything in their collection, Picasso, Van Gogh's, Raphael's. They would often sit together and admire the great works of art. Well, this is about battle and military. When the Vietnam conflict broke out, the son went to war. He was a very courageous young man and died in battle rescuing another soldier. The father was notified and grieved deeply for his son. About a month later, just before Christmas, there was a knock. A young man stood at the old man's door with a large package in his hands. He said, "Sir, you don't know me, but I am the soldier for whom your son gave his life. He saved many lives that day. And he was carrying me to safety when a bullet struck him in the heart, and he died instantly. He often talked about you, sir, and your love for art and how much he loved his dad." The young man held out his package. He knew, "I know that this isn't much," he told the man, "and I'm not really a great artist, but I think your son would have wanted you to have this." The old man opened the package. It was a portrait of his son, painted by the young soldier. He stared in awe at the way the soldier had captured the personality of his son in the painting. The father was so drawn to the eyes that his own eyes welled up with tears. He thanked the young man and offered to pay him for the picture, and he said, "No, sir, I could never repay what your son did for me. It's a gift." The father hung the portrait over his mantle. Every time visitors came to his home, he took them to see the portrayal of his son before he showed him the great works of art that he had collected, the Van Goghs, the Raphaels. The man died a few months later. There was to be a great auction of his paintings. Many people came excited over seeing the great paintings, have an opportunity to buy one for their collection. On the platform sat the painting of the sun. The auctioneer pounded his gavel. "We'll start the bidding with a picture of the sun. Who will bid for the sun?" There was absolute silence. Then a voice in the back of the room shouted, "We came to see the famous paintings. Skip this one of the sun." But the auctioneer persisted. "Will someone bid for the painting of the sun? Who will start? $100, $200. Another voice angrily said, "We didn't come here to see this painting. We came to see the Van Goghs, the Rembrandts. Get on with the real bidding." But still the auctioneer persisted and continued, the sun, who will take the sun?" Finally, a voice came from the back of the room. It was a longtime gardener of the father and the son. "I'll give $10 for the painting. Being a poor man, this is all he could afford." "We have $10. Can we get 20 for the picture of the sun? 30, going once, going twice, going three times, $10 for the picture of the sun." Then they yelled out, let's see the masters. Let's see the Rembrandts, the Van Goghs." The crowd was becoming very angry. They didn't want the picture of the sun. They wanted the more worthy investments. The auctioneer pounded his gravel. "Going once, going twice, sold." A man sitting in the section shouted, "Now we can see the collection." The auctioneer laid down his gavel. He said, "I'm sorry, the auction is over." "What about the paintings? What about the paintings? Let's get to them." "I'm sorry, when I called to conduct this auction, I was told of a very secret stipulation in the will. I was not allowed to reveal the stipulation till this time. Only the painting of the sun would be auctioned." Whoever bought the painting of the sun inherited the whole estate, including the paintings. So you see, The man that took the Son got everything. We need to all humble ourselves in the mighty hand of God. With our family and our friends. There's so many people that cannot forgive other people. We need to run to that throne of grace and get on our knees and forgive them from the bottom of our heart. Don't miss the Son. Like I tell people, if you don't get to know me, I'm nobody. You haven't lost anything. But if you miss the Son, you've lost everything.